Pleomorphic adenoma is the most common benign salivary gland tumor that most commonly affects the parotid glands. It is basically a tumor comprising of epithelial and myoepithelial cells in a stroma showing a variety of mesenchymal components. Now to understand this better, let's recap the basic structure of salivary glands. Secretory cells present in salivary glands are of two types, the serous and the mucous cells. Now these secretory cells are housed in secretory end pieces. And serous and mucous cells line the lumen of the secretory end pieces. These secretory end pieces are continuous with the main excretory duct of the salivary gland through many intermediary ducts. The lumen of the end piece opens into the intercalated duct, which is continuous with the striated duct, which in turn opens into the excretory duct of the salivary gland. Also note that the ducts are lined by ductal cells. Now the secretory end pieces and intercalated ducts are associated with stellate-shaped contractile cells called myoepithelial cells. A myoepithelial cell is an epithelial cell that has smooth muscle-like contractile properties. One among the many functions of this myoepithelial cell is to contract and help secrete saliva from end pieces to the ducts. So pleomorphic adenoma comprises of neoplastic epithelial or ductal cells and myoepithelial cells. It has been reported by studies that these neoplastic myoepithelial cells, ductal cells, or both may undergo mesenchymal metaplasia to give rise to varied tissue components like chondroid, myxoid, chondromyxoid, and very rarely osseous and adipose tissue, which comprises the connective tissue or stroma. The term pleomorphic in pleomorphic adenoma should not be confused with pleomorphism that is used to describe atypical cells in dysplastic lesions. Pleomorphic in this context is used to describe the mixture of epithelial cells as well as the variety of mesenchymal tissue types under the microscope. This tumor was also referred to as a mixed tumor for the same reason and was thought to arise from multiple germ layers. This, however, is not the case, as the varied stromal components are derived as a result of mesenchymal metaplasia of the neoplastically altered myoepithelial and epithelial cells. Also, cytogenetic studies demonstrate gene alterations in the PLAG1 and the HMGA2 genes in the long arms of chromosomes 8 and 12 respectively. So pleomorphic adenoma is the most common benign salivary gland tumor, affecting the major and the minor salivary glands. Parotid gland is the most common site, followed by the submandibular gland and the minor salivary glands. Sublingual glands are rarely affected. The palatal glands are the most commonly affected minor salivary glands. Now this tumor has a female predilection and occurs in the elderly between the 4th to 6th decade. The tumor presents as a slow-growing, painless swelling, and the superficial lobe of the parotid gland is usually affected, with the swelling occurring just in front and below the ear. The tumor can grow to large sizes if left unattended to. Under the microscope, pleomorphic adenoma shows two kinds of tumor cells, the ductal epithelial cells and the myoepithelial cells. Now, the ductal epithelial cells are cuboidal and usually proliferate in the form of ducts, tubules, or solid sheets. Eosinophilic secretions can be found in the duct lumen. The ductal cells may also show squamous, oncocytic, and mucous metaplasia. Spindle-shaped myoepithelial cells can be seen surrounding the ductal or the tubular elements. The myoepithelial cells can also be seen proliferating separately as sheets. Myoepithelial cells may lose their spindle shape and become polygonal to oval shape. And these polygonal or oval-shaped myoepithelial cells have an eosinophilic cytoplasm and an eccentrically placed nucleus and are called plasmacytoid cells. These are so called because of their resemblance to plasma cells, which are oval and have an eccentric nucleus. The stroma of this tumor varies from being myxoid to fibrous and also sometimes hyalinized. Various other mesenchymal elements like chondroid, osseous, and adipose tissue can also be seen. Most importantly, pleomorphic adenoma is encapsulated and has a surrounding fibrous capsule. As far as the treatment is concerned, surgical excision of the tumor is the treatment of choice in both the major and the minor salivary glands. This is accomplished by local resection with minimal surrounding tissue. In case the parotid gland is involved, surgical removal should be accomplished without damage to the facial nerve.